job is being an educator, so I'm an assistant principal of a high school in Brooklyn, New York, and I was a high school teacher before that. However, I like to think my part-time job is being a travel blogger, just because I'm so into traveling, and you know, I've now decided to put it into words. I was born in Brooklyn, Caribbean rooted, so my mom is from Haiti, so I like to use the term Caribbean. And then also, I would describe myself as unapologetically Black. So in terms of where my travel inspiration comes from, so growing up, I didn't have the means to travel, so I grew up very below the poverty line. And so my mom and I, we always used to take adventures like throughout New York or try to step into like Jersey or Connecticut. So a lot of the curiosity was like we would just hop on bus rides in Brooklyn, going from like Bay Ridge to Park Slope to Flatbush. And so that had me curious in terms of like what is outside of New York City, although New York definitely has a lot to offer. And then when I got to high school, I actually fell in love with global history. And so that made me want to explore the world more. So when I was in college, I was actually pre-med, but I specifically decided to major in history also, just so I can learn more about global cultures. And then I specifically also focused on colonialism, and so that also gained my interest, especially in Caribbean culture and learning more of my history and my story. When it came to traveling, I actually never got on a plane until I was 22 years old. I was sent to a science teacher conference by myself, going to the random state of Indiana. And so I was like, we're gonna just dive in real quick. At that point, I didn't even have a passport either, but that summer, I had decided to take a trip to Costa Rica with my friend. As like, oh, this is, I'm done with my first year teaching, this is how I'm gonna celebrate. So that pushed me to get my passport, and I feel like that trip is where I caught the travel bug. But it was interesting because during my first year teaching, I think there were like two people who I feel like motivated me to travel. So I had one coworker, at that point she had traveled to like 80 countries, and I'm like, I haven't been to any, so I need to step my game up. And then I had a professor from grad school who was like, education is one of the best fields because you get these extended breaks. Like, you get a week off for Christmas, you get a week off for spring break, you get a summer, and so you literally can be visiting a different place every single break. And I think I took that literally because over time, I always made sure, even if it was like Columbus Day weekend, it's like, I'm gonna fly out Friday, come back Monday, be at work on Tuesday. And so I would balance it of like international and domestic travel. So like, for example, this Columbus Day is like, I'm going to go to St. Louis, Missouri. That was
nice.
Because I'm like, I want to see all 50 states, haven't been there yet. But then on an extended break, it's like, I'm going to go to like Prague or Budapest because I saw a travel deal that lined up perfectly during my break. And so as a result, I think as I began to travel over time, having my friends be inspired, having a lot of my students who often don't step outside the borough of Brooklyn or outside the neighborhood, and hearing of like, oh, miss, I'm gonna do that someday, I think has pushed me to wanna continue to keep traveling. So why do I travel so long? So as you say, just tired of waiting. So I think a pivotal point where this became super real was this was summer 2016, and at that point, I just finished 5 years of teaching. I was about to move to a new school, to my new job as assistant principal, and I was like, I don't know how much break I'm gonna have with this job. So I was like, I need to go somewhere. I was just hitting up friends of like, oh, like I found a really good deal in like Ecuador, let's go. And then you would just hear like, the money's not lining up, I gotta make a car payment, even though you agreed 2 months ago. So I always felt like when it came time to putting down the money, friends would always not come through. And so at that point, I was like, I'm either gonna sit here and not go on vacation before I start this like big moment in my life, or I'm gonna just go. And so I decided to go. I scaffolded in a way where I went with a travel tour group. So I didn't know anyone. I had to like fly to Ecuador and everything. And then when I got there was where I met a whole bunch of random people. people, and it's actually a lot of those people we still Facebook message today, from a 70-year-old woman in Iowa to like a 25-year veteran teacher in Atlanta, and we're always like, oh, when are we gonna travel again? And so they become close friends. The other thing, as Indigo was talking about, is like, you don't need to compromise at all when you travel. So I could decide to lay in my bed till 12 p.m. and then go on a brunch and then go on a stroll in the neighborhood, or I could wake up super early to do a crazy excursion, but not having to compromise on how much money someone wants to spend or when to wake up is huge. So in terms of places I have traveled solo, so like I said, Ecuador was my first time, and then I have gone to Haiti, Canada, so this was like west coast of Canada, so I feel like it's like super far. Also Morocco, Spain, ended up on accident as a result of like missing a flight to come back home from Morocco because of someone else's immigration issue, and then just traveling all over the United States. And so I'm at a point where I want to see all 50 states. It would be ideal to see at least 50 countries before turning 50. Clearly my state count is a lot higher, but I feel like I started off telling people like I want to go to like two new states in one country a year, and then somehow that country count has been like two, three, four. Like I just start, you know, following the flight deals, and then it gets me there. And so just in terms of top five tips I could think of in terms of traveling solo. So I feel like a lot of people think like traveling solo means traveling internationally, but I think you have to just get comfortable with your own company. So I remember having this conversation at work, and a coworker was like, yeah, I realized I don't think I've even traveled like to another state or sat in a restaurant by myself or go to a movie by myself. So it's like, before you can make that jump to be like, you know, roaming Europe, you need to be able to feel comfortable, like whether it's like sitting in a restaurant in New York City, whether it's going to another state. I think just like building your way up, you'll feel more comfortable. Also planning ahead, but not planning too crazy ahead. So you do want to have an idea of like the political climate or any travel advisories or food and culture, but some of the best moments are the most spontaneous. Like the Spain, that was like a complete accident, but ended up being one of the best trips and some of the best food I had, because I had to last minute figure out like what is there to do in Madrid. I got 24 hours in a free hotel as a result of being stuck there. For me, I feel comfortable someone back home knowing where I am. So for me, it's my mama. I always make sure she knows my flight info, my hotel info, the general itinerary. I know a big thing people get concerned is like, sure. So like this is Morocco and I was by myself. However, what ends up happening is like, one, sometimes I target like families who I see are like, oh, you need to get in that picture because if you take for me, I can take for you. Also, what I'll notice with couples, when you have that boyfriend who's like kneeling, taking all the angles for his girl, they usually take really good photos as well. Otherwise, you know, you really become really good with the selfie angles and the selfie stick. And then the last thing, I mean, realizing traveling solo doesn't necessarily mean that you are alone. What I found is that a lot of the times when you go by yourself, you're willing to talk to other people, or people are drawn to talk to you. So I remember trying to go to a restaurant in Canada and it was like fully booked, but they were squeezing me in for an hour because they were like, you're by yourself. And I'm like, I got you. 1 hour, I'm gonna make this work. And so if you're also wanting to meet other people, like if you use websites such as Viator where you can book like day excursion, or there's websites like Free Tours by Foot where you could do free walking tours and there's gonna be other people there, or choosing a tour group because there's a lot of companies. Like there's lots of ways to put yourself in situations where you're going to be surrounded by people, but the good option is you can decide to opt out and just be by yourself.
Yes. So thank you. You remind me, I didn't even talk about the design of all